the top 100 board games of all time.
Smile.
The 90s Winner's Circle. So, obviously, horse racing game, but beginning of the game, you bet on different horses. And then you roll this dice. And you apply the effects of the icon onto one of these lovely little horses here. Okay. And depending on what you bet, the horse that comes in first, second, or third, you get a payout for that. And it's also a great game from the old master, Rainer Canisia. That's the stuff. Number 89 is this little gem, Cockroach Poker. This is like a fantastic bluffing game. With my old mate, this stink bug. Everyone gets a hand of cards. Basically, all you're doing is you're just passing a card to somebody and telling them what it is. But you can lie, you can tell the truth if you want. And then the person that takes the card's got an option of either looking at it or take it into their hand. And basically, what you want to do is just get a set of bugs. So you've got different types of bugs here. Just remind me of a few people that I've met in the past. But yeah, so. Brilliant, brilliant bluffing game. Should always be in your collection. Number 88 is going gone. Basically, this one is like a sort of an auction game. You get these cups, and you just basically chuck in these little cubes into these cups based on an arbitrary timer. So, and you'll be auctioning off all of these different cards. So you've got countries and you've got goods on the cards on. Yeah, it's great. Frantic Mayhem. 87 is New York Slice. This comes in a fantastic looking pizza box like that. Brilliant. So what you're doing with this one is you're constructing pizza, sticking bonus cards on top of the pizza, and it's a case of like I split, you choose. So if when it's your go, you split the pizza, and then the next person or the person who's before you will choose a portion of the pizza that you just split. But the thing is, the person that goes last gets to choose the first bit. So yeah, so this is cheap and cheerful, it's quick, and you should buy it. Number 86 is the old dice chucking classic, King of Tokyo. So this is basically Yahtzee with power up cards, basically. So yeah, you're chucking dice, keeping some, rolling them again, keeping some, and you're trying to basically knock out your opponents without getting knocked out yourself. But the problem is that you can't heal when you're in Tokyo. But yeah, I mean, Richard Garfield, hats off to you, mate. It's a killer. Number 85, one of our favourite party games with some wagers. This is it's great for people that are thick, and there's plenty of people I know that are thick. Because you don't actually have to know the answers for this one, so everyone writes down all the questions are numbers based. So you all just write down a number, and if you're closest to the answer, then you win the point. So yeah, this is it's awesome. Number 84. It's another dexterity game. It's Dungeon Fighter. We've got all the expansions in here, all of them. So what you're doing, you're chucking dice onto a target, trying to wound monsters as you work your way through a dungeon. And you can buy power upgrades. And the main thing about this one is that a lot of the monsters, they require you to throw the dice in funny poses, like between your legs, with your eyes closed. Someone's got to hold your hand while you're doing it. This is hard. I mean, this is insane. Number 83, it's Chinatown. If you want a game about negotiation, this is your one. So everything can be negotiated. So everything, money, property, everything. So basically what you're trying to do, you're trying to acquire restaurants, but you only score points when the restaurants are adjacent to each other. So yeah, I mean, this is insane. I mean, you can have some right laughs with this, but I wouldn't play it with people that don't like to be stitched up, you know what I mean? Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Number 82, Jungle Speed. Don't play this game with people with long nails. So you've got a totem pole that's in the middle of the table. Everyone gets a hand of cards with symbols on them. See these symbols? And these symbols, you're basically flipping over a card. And when two cards match, you got to try and grab the totem pole. But problem being is that a lot of these symbols, they look similar, but they don't match. So you try and grab the totem pole and you think, yeah. So don't play this with people with long nails. Julie, looking at you. Right, number 81 is this beast. It's Crokinole, ancient Canadian game, disc flicking. This is probably one of my favorite dexterity games. Not the favorite, well, any game on this list is good. But yeah, you're trying to flip discs into this hole here, but the problem being is that before you flick it into the hole, you have to hit one of your own discs. So yeah, awesome, if not a bit, not very portable.